There is no doubt that modern-day skyscrapers are awesome to look. Actually, the strength of such architectures depends on the elastic properties of the materials that are used during the construction. So, the concept of elasticity is very much important for any kind of manufacturing or construction work. Hello and welcome. Myself Subhadip Roy, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, Mallabhum Institute of Technology. Today, I am going to give a brief idea about the procedure of measuring the elastic constant known as shear modulus or modulus of rigidity of the material of a wire in a lab experiment scenario. I would like to thank my colleague Mr. Dulal Chatterjee for demonstrating this experiment. Let us start. Aim of our experiment. The aim is to determine the rigidity modulus of the material of a wire by dynamic method. The scheme of this experiment is that a cylinder is suspended using the wire of which the rigidity modulus is to be calculated. The upper end of this wire is fixed in a rigid support and the cylinder can be made to oscillate so that a pointer attached to it moves over a graduated circular scale. This forms a torsional pendulum whose time period can be determined with the help of a stopwatch. Since the total experiment is done by moving the torsional pendulum, this experiment is known as to be dynamic in nature. The main theory behind this experiment is that the rigidity modulus is the ratio of shearing stress to the shearing strain within the elastic limit. In this figure, a block is undergoing a shearing stress and as a result, its side is bent through an angle theta. So if we can measure the displacement of the upper portion, here it is denoted by del x, with respect to the angle of shear, then we can find the rigidity modulus. In our experiment, the theory is depending on this concept and the working formula is given by eta equals to 8 pi L divided by t square r to the power 4 into half m r square. Here, in this formula, the capital T denotes the time period of oscillation of the bob. The small l denotes the length of the suspension wire. Small r denotes radius of the wire. Capital R denotes the radius of the cylinder and capital M stands for the mass of the cylinder. So from this theory, it is quite clear that we have to make the measurements of time period, length of the wire, radius of the wire, radius of the cylinder and the mass of the cylinder. If we can get all these values, then we can just put this in this formula and we will be getting the value of the rigidity modulus for the material of the wire. So let's start the procedure. First one, let us start with the screw gauge instrument. Screw gauge is an instrument which is used to measure very small distances. Here we are using the screw gauge for the measurement of radius of the wire. Here is the demonstration. Second one is the measuring the length of the suspension wire from the point of suspension to the point where the cylinder is attached by a meter scale. Here is the demonstration. The next step is to measure the diameter of the cylindrical bob with the help of a slide calipers. Let's look at the demonstration. And the last part is to calculate the time period of oscillation. Here, the cylindrical bob is to be rotated by a very small angle, and we are going to measure the time period for several oscillations, and then we can get the time period for a single oscillation. After getting all the values of time period, length, radius, and mass, we can put these values in the working formula to calculate the value of eta. The standard values for different materials of shear modulus is given in this chart. You can see for steel it is 80 to 100 kilonewton per millimeter square. For wrought iron it is 80 to 90. For cast iron it is 40 to 50, and for copper, brass and timber the values are given in the table. So this was a very brief video about the determination of modulus of rigidity using our laboratory facilities. Thank you very much.